For the best water deals in town, your local needs. Fill up your 18.9 liter for the low price of only $2 or your 4 liter for only 50 cents. Pure Aqua Valley Water.
Moncton Wildcats Assistant Director of Hockey Operations, Richie Thibeau, joining me here at TD Station. And Richie, I was just getting, looking for an update here. I know that your head coach, John Torchetti, a leave of absence. Can you update us?
Yeah, John is away from the team on a personal leave. It's the statement we made last Tuesday, and there's really no update beyond that point at this time.
I have to wonder, it's a little difficult to follow the story, but what can you share with us that perhaps may have occurred over the last week that might lead us to a conclusion here?
Well, there's really nothing for me to talk about at this point. As we've stated, it is a personal matter, and we want to leave it at that at this point.
Is he the head coach?
Yes, John is still currently the head coach of this team.
Okay. Has this impacted, his leave of absence, impacted the team, if at all?
Well, for us, we have a good leadership group amongst the players. We've got a couple of assistant coaches that have been involved from day one into our program. So, you know, we're moving along, making sure that the team is ready to play. We had a tough road trip in Quebec. We played well, and we're looking to finish out strong in our last three games before Christmas.
Your head coach, a leave of absence. Has that impacted on the players at all?
No, I don't think too much. I think, as part of the leadership group, we've been trying to keep it kind of an open door. And, it's a personal leave, so we don't really know too much. But I think we're in good hands with Daryl and Ryan Salvis. So I think our team's been playing pretty well. We haven't really got the results, but we're going to continue to, kind of play for each other.
Since he's been on this leave of absence, how well has this team played?
Well, they're 1-3-0-0 during his absence. They've had some ups and downs. They're not playing as well. I mean, I have to believe this has been a distraction. How can it not be? One of their losses now was a 6-3 loss, an empty net goal in Sherbrooke. They played very well. They outchanced Sherbrooke. They lost the game on goaltending and special teams, so I can't say they didn't play badly that game at all. They played really well, actually. But they're not playing at the same level now as they were before, and I got to think these players are scratching their head. I mean, how can these players not be wondering what the heck is going on? I mean, John left the team on the Friday night, didn't make the trip to Cape Breton. Then he came back, and he was on the ice on Tuesday, and he ran practice. And then he didn't make the road trip the next day to go to Quebec, and they said, and I interviewed John on the Monday night, and John said, that he was going to be making, he told me in the interview Monday night that he would be making the road, that he was running practice Tuesday, making the road trip to Quebec on Wednesday. And then, I guess later on, I'm not sure if it was his choice or somebody else told him that his leave of absence is not over, and he's still on leave of absence. So he was telling me his leave of absence was over, and the team was saying, no, it's not. So if he is going to come back, and I think it's a big if right at this stage, I would think it would be the first game after Christmas, have a fresh start, second half. That's what I see happening if he comes back. Or I wouldn't be surprised to see an entirely new head coach behind the bench on December 28th when they play their first game after Christmas. I mean, this is a team that's built to win this year. It's one of the top 3-4 contenders in the league. They're going to bring, if he doesn't come back, I definitely think that they'll bring in an experienced head coach.